Alright, this place seems calm enough. Let's go exploring, huh? It's so pretty and serene. I'm sure nothing horrible is gonna happen here. No disturbing shit, I'm sure. That was easy. Yeah, I flub up pretty much immediately in this temple, because I could have sworn I remember something from my first time playing. Yeah, and there are those little lily pads with hooks underneath, which we'll need the temple item, the whip, for later on. Giant spiders, no big deal. Yeah, I know if you like roll into them a certain way, you can just go on through, but I fuck it up. Yeah, so here's the thing. Yeah, this temple's secret order. I could have sworn I remembered it, but I don't because I'm a dingus. But the thing is, this little lock right here is the only time you need to know this order. It never comes up again, I'm pretty sure. I hate these spiders and their giant webs. Well, the good news is, with this flub up, is I can show you a way to make an easy 200 rupees. So that's nice. They're in the palms of the Buddha's hands. Yeah, this is a little bit of a creepy looking Buddha. Yeah, so for anyone who knows Buddhist mythology, I guess you'll have a nice time with this place. Yep, there it is. If you cash the money from my hand, you can keep it. Unless you get caught. Like a dingus. But it's really easy. You just gotta... there, like that. Why does he have a spiral on his thumb? Well, I guess a fingerprint, but... very, pronounced. Boy, I sure do love having to spin my way up onto ledges. That sure is fun, by gum. Like, no, really, I hate the swimming mechanics in this game so much. They're so horrible. Gotta get in front of the statue. There we go. Yeah, carved into the great statue is the secret order. But I don't do it that way. I just kind of bullshit my way through it. But there is the other hand you gotta do, and giant gears for some reason. I wonder what the deal with that is. I'm sure that will not become important later. Ah, who am I kidding? It definitely will. And yeah, there are water choo-choos in this game. You know, you just can't escape these guys. Green ones for the forest, burning ones for the lava world, and electrified ones for the Lanayru Desert. Just can't get rid of them. You cannot escape these fuckers. They'll follow you to the ends of the earth. There we go. But yeah, see, you gotta look on the back of the hand to see the secret order. And you gotta, you know, look at them in each direction in the order the sign tells you, but I don't bother with that. I just kind of guess. I managed to do it. I managed to actually do it on my first guess after this. I don't know, I guess I just kind of remembered. But yeah, again, you never need to do this again. This whole order of the temple thing never comes up again. I'm like 99% sure. So why bother? Yeah, being able to do that will become important later. Link, you okay? Having a brain aneurysm there? There we go. I think I just had my revelation. Yeah, there you go. See, like that. If you roll through a web like that, things become a lot easier. Yeah, I'm just reiterating here that this is the temple's secret order, and it never comes up again. Ever. So yeah, it's up, down, left, right. Yeah, there's a puzzle like this later on, but it doesn't have the same order, so doesn't count. And it's in a different temple, so doubly doesn't count. Yeah, I see that spider up there. I didn't see that one, though. God, the skull tool is in this game. The skulls actually look kind of creepy this time around. Ugh. hate bugs. I really hate spiders. I hate arachnids. And I get to kill some tiny ones. Or one. If I can hit it. There we go. Yeah, so, yeah, the item from this temple is kind of lame, too. I mean, it's a whip. It can only stun enemies. It's like a slingshot, almost. It can only stun enemies. But it can get you some crafting items if you use it in certain situations. But overall, it's kind of a lame duck, in my opinion. I think there's actually a whip in another Zelda game, I think. It's been a while since I played. I think it's a 2D one. Like, I'm 90% sure there's a whip in one of them. But I can't remember which one. Anyway. Not important. I think this is the treasure chest that has it, actually. Or maybe it's just a small key. I guess we'll see. I guess we'll find out. Yeah, just a small key. It's okay. It's okay to be wrong about whatever's in a treasure chest. You know, why did the plant have a tongue? And teeth? Well, I guess the Venus flytrap kind of has teeth. But it doesn't have a tongue, I can tell you that much. I'm no botanist, but I can tell you that much. I want a Venus flytrap, I think those are kind of cool. And they can help get rid of flies and mosquitoes and shit. Right? Right. But yeah, there was a lily pad that was already hook side upward that you gotta whip. It's right around, well, actually, after I don't have the whip yet. What am I thinking? I think it's down in this hole. Huh. Ruby? Yeah, and there's the boss, that's where the keyhole goes already. The boss key. God, shut the fuck up, please. Hey, what's this? Oh, God, it's a more powerful Stalfos. I think it's a Stalfos Knight? Oh, it's grumpy. It's crossing its arms. Yeah, these things are a pain in the ass. Yeah, why do they do that with their swords? Like, haha, can't hit me this way, haha. Look how powerful I am. But yeah, it's more just annoying. It's not hard, honestly. Even after it unleashes its two other arms. Yeah, like that. I'm not afraid of you, forearms. But yeah, sometimes it'll make you have to stab it, you know, a thrust, and it, of course, it never works. I can never get my sword to, you know, thrust that way, so. Oh, there goes its, what just came off? It wasn't his helmet. I think I just saw a piece of armor come off, though, didn't I? Yeah, don't get too close. Yeah, I thought I was out of its range. Why are there Pokoblin skulls in here? That's ominous. But I'm sure that won't be important. And maybe that's a little bit of foreshadowing for later on. God, just die. Why don't you die, enemy? I don't like you. So please die. Its helmet should be coming off any second now. Which signifies it's almost dead. Yeah, so, I thinking back to it, I probably should have used the bomb trick on this guy. There we go, there goes his helmet. It's a triclops. That's interesting. So, or maybe it's a jewel or something? Or is that a third eye? I don't know. There it goes. That's silly. Why did it do that? Why did it scuttle about so comically, eh? Yes, I can. I know I have low hearts. Thank you. Good thing the Bokoblins apparently keep their hearts inside their heads. I don't know, maybe that's where they have two hearts instead of a brain. Ah, here we go. Here's the whip. I needed to get the hell out of here. There we go. So yeah, got the whip. Whip it good. I only got two more items left until I got a full inventory. Yeah, and so these are switches to... Well, I guess... Can you call them a switch? That you gotta use your whip on. You've got to whip them. Whip them good. Yes, two whip them good references in less than a minute. Quality commentary right there. Yeah, you have to get further up, but you can't do much up there right now. But, no, I don't explore yet. Because I know there's that lily pad with the hook on it. Somewhere around here. There it is. Gotta use it to get to that switch. And you can actually use your whip on those switches. No, I mean, you have to at certain points. Got no choice during certain parts of the game. Yeah, so it's an interesting little mechanic, I guess. I mean, it's not like a bat. It's better than the Gust Bellows, that's for sure. Nothing is worse than the Gust Bellows. Shut your trap! Yeah. Yeah, and that helps, yeah. Lead you to this tunnel here. I hope there's treasure in here. Nope, just a spider. I hate that. I want to see a giant. I just want some treasure, and then I see a giant spider. Oh God! No! Bad touch! Bad touch! Never do that again. Shame on you. Just seeing if there's any like a small rupee chest back here, and there is. Oh boy! I hope it's 20 rupees. Oh man, I was right. 20 rupees. How did I know? Yeah, but there's a whip switch somewhere. Yeah, it's on the other side of the bars, which is a little mechanic, because you can whip through bars, which is kind of cool, I think. Yep, like that. It's kind of cool. Very Indiana Jones. Except I don't think Indiana Jones ever did that. I don't know. It's been a while since I've seen the movies. Yeah, the archers in this game, the archer bokoblins are very easy to kill. Like, one hit and they're dead, basically. And I haven't even powered up my sword yet. Yeah, as you get the flames, you actually get upgrades to your sword. Which is nice. Really makes it feel like you're becoming, you know, more powerful as a warrior, you know? Well, actually, the Nehru flame is kind of a lame duck in comparison. Yeah, this is bullshit right here. Yeah, bullshit. Like, the very tip of my foot touched it. Come on. I call BS. Yeah, I don't think falling into bottomless pits even hurt you in this game. I don't think I even lost any hearts with that from that. Which is... I guess that's weird, but I don't know. Guess I don't mind. I despise you archers. I die. Ah, I heard it sprout out of heart. It loves me. But yeah, you gotta whip it from the ground, I think. That's how you do it. It's hard to Z target though. Cause I know that's what you gotta do, I'm pretty sure. Again, it's been a while since I don't remember all the puzzles. So we'll be going through this adventure together. Yeah, okay, yeah, now I can Z-target it. Alright, I think I just jump on it? Okay, yeah. I don't know. But, yeah, the temple looks like rainbows and sunshine for now, but it gets much darker later on. Well, it's not that bad, honestly. I mean, I'm exaggerating it a bit, but it is kind of creepy. Especially the first time playing it was. Ah, jelly bobs. Still don't know how these things come from these Deku Babas, but whatever. a boring wad of gunk. It has like a, it has like, I don't know, it's got body parts in there. What would it be, like a membrane? I don't fucking know. I don't know stuff like that. What do me look like? Me look like scientist? Give you a nickel if you jump in there. Oh. Into the whirlpool you go, Link. That's not into the whirlpool, Link. This was a bad idea! I immediately... Aw, man, just got flushed down the toilet. I wonder if he saw Mario on the way there. Get it? Because Mario goes in pipes? But yeah, so this is kind of the under area of the temple. Just gets worse from here. Much worse, much more terrifying. Not that terrifying. Again, I'm just exaggerating. It's actually not really that bad. And compared to some other Zelda games, it's pretty tame. Especially the Shadow Temple. Oh man, that spider is drowned. That's pretty gruesome, actually. Yeah, I'll let that one spider live. So you can tell the others what he saw. Yeah, they'll fear me. They'll come to fear me soon enough. Hark, I hear a noise. Sounds like a bokoblin. It looks like one too. And it smells like one too. Ugh. Yeah, so here's a little mechanic where you can, you know, get a key from it. But I don't think you ever do this again. Like, I don't think you ever have to do that ever again in the game. So, what's the point? I mean, yeah, it's a neat little thing, but it'll be nice if you could do it more than once, you know? Huh. That looks dark and ominous. But I think I see... maybe, Ah, yes! The boss key chest! Uh-huh, are you sure? A chest, you say? Uh-huh, I think those contain things, right? Oh, you're not gonna get away with that. Not gonna get away with trying to kill me that easily, bub. But yeah, we'll be back there later. We got a little bit of fiddling to do with that giant statue in the middle of the temple before we can go down to that area proper. Well, that specific area of the undertow, as it were. So yeah, actually, I really like this temple, actually. I mean, I mostly like it for the under part of it. Because I like the jarring kind of, like, change in the temple. I kind of like the Buddhist mythology symbolism and the... I think it's interesting. Even though I really don't know that much about Buddhist mythology. I do got a map, though. I got a piece of paper. That's nice. Yeah, there's nothing left to do up here except open a chest. For the most part. Yep. There's a little... yeah, it's actually kind of a small temple when you look at it. There's really not much to do left in here. Actually, there is a bit. It seems like there's not a lot. But we'll get to that when we get to that. Right now, I just gotta whip some stuff. Aha! I love that, whipping a spider. That's never a sight I thought I'd see until I played this game. Whipping a spider. Very weird. Kind of odd. But kind of cool. Ooh, so close. Die already. I'll kill it eventually, I'm sure. Use the bomb on it. No, no, that works. So yeah, all you gotta do is just that. Nothing doing. And I can get some money out of it too. There we go. God, these pufferfish things are everywhere. How do they even live like this where touching things make them blow up in a very very fiery death. I was trying to look for another word there, but I couldn't quite find it. I was gonna say they blow up like a bomb does. They don't blow up in like fleshy bits. They blow up like they're filled with fuck, I don't know. Explosive material. I don't fucking know. Ah, that's useful. So yeah, you can probably guess what we gotta do there. I think that I just have to get a that goes to a door, which leads me to another area, which lets me flip a switch, I think, that'll help with the statue. That's what I think happens. But we will be investigating that in just a minute or two. Yeah, but I don't finish off the temple until the next video. I think, yeah. I really love the boss in this temple. It's my favorite boss battle in this game. It's honestly one of the better Zelda bosses in general, in my opinion. And there are those giant birds, which you need the whip to take down effectively. Yeah, I think it's just like a rupee chest over here or something. Like over yonder. Yeah, yonder. Haven't you ever heard of that direction? Yonder? Yeah, see, it's just a rupee chest. But I gotta get it anyway. Gotta get all the money I can. So I can wind up like that guy in Twilight Princess. The greed will overtake me and I shall sell my soul for cash. What a horrible way to go. I think there's actually a reference to him in this game. I think the largest wallet of the game is actually modeled after him. I don't remember his name, but you know, the guy you had to collect the pole souls for in Twilight Princess. That guy. I don't remember his name. Eh, it's not important. He was just a dumb, greedy, fatty fat. Actually, no, his real form was, like, skinny now that I think about it, wasn't it? It's been a while since I played that game. But I'm pretty sure his true form was actually kind of skinny. Yeah. I actually like Twilight Princess quite a bit. And I actually really like the kind of gritty, somewhat edgy, realistic graphics. I actually like those. I wonder what this switch will do. Only one way to find out. Ah, it makes water come out. For a shortcut, of course, but... which is helpful, I suppose. But now let's see what this switch does. Oh shit! Buddha, don't go! I'm sorry! I didn't mean to insult you! Well, there's his giant feet. Yeah, that's where so he blocks off the chest with his feet. So we're gonna have to find a way to get down there and move his feet. Gosh dang it, the heck, Buddha. Why do you gotta be such a pain? But yeah, now I think you just gotta go back down. I'll figure it out, don't you worry. Yeah, so that's what the giant gears are for. To help move the Buddha. Yeah, and avoid the underbelly of the lily pads. They hurt. But yeah, so we're gonna see the darker side of the temple down here. I mean, it's not that bad, really. I kind of exaggerate it, but it's kind of unnerving the first time if you're like a little kid, maybe, I don't know. And there's another water spout. Just going off to see. Yeah, so that's actually the, kind of the, not really a door, but, yeah, so. I'm exaggerating my anger, just so you know. I'm not really in this angry FI. Ah, yes, the water shall catch me. And give me hypothermia. Okay, let's go explore the bottom of the temple. I hope it's not too dark down there. I didn't bring a flashlight. Oh no, bokoblins. However am I gonna... they look a little bit different. Oh god, oh no. Nope. Ugh. So yeah, this is what the bottom of the temple looks like. Literally hell. Oh god, it's pretty, they're actually kind of disturbing looking. So yeah, I guess these are just the bokoblins I've killed throughout the game. Yeah, touching the blood curses you, so you can't use your weapons. Yeah, these are the closest things to re-deads that the game has. But luckily they don't do that scream thing that paralyzes you. They do grapple onto you and, you know, act like a zombie. Act like zombies. So yeah, I guess this is just hell. Those are the bokoblins I've killed in the past. Huh. So yeah, this is the disturbing part of the temple, but it really isn't that bad. There's a waterfall of blood though, so that's something. But yeah, I'm gonna cut it out here because it actually takes me a bit of time to figure out what to do, and I don't actually do it until the next part, so I'll just end it right here. Next time I'll go venturing deeper down to what is probably hell, and